The southern border. First it was a crisis, then it wasn't, then it was. What could it be now?
This president just used the backdrop of the Oval Office to manufacture a crisis.
Right now, we have a crisis at our southern border.
Some question if there is a crisis at all, as the president has claimed.
When we do have a crisis at the border.
An intelligence official tells CNN, quote, no one is saying this is a crisis except them.
We sit down instantly to start negotiating and into this border security crisis.
But no sign of the national emergency that the president has been talking about. As a matter of fact, it's pretty tranquil down here.
Crisis, no crisis, crisis. The media is like your dumb friend you ask to step out of the car to see if the blinkers are working. Yeah, it's working. Not working. Working. Not working. How can you make sense of this? Journalism these days is just another form of hysteria. A cynical person might think that if the press can't pin the crisis on you, then the crisis doesn't exist. Meanwhile, we see the crisis with our own eyes. We see the coyotes as people who traffic in suffering. The media just sees them as goofy, colorful tour guides. That's a result of childish denial. It'll make you say anything other than the truth, stuff that borders on the obscene. The border crisis is a long-term problem that makes problem solvers in the short term look like the bad guys. You're the parent threatening to take away the kids' avocados. Meanwhile, the Dems and media don't know what a crisis actually is. They're like a sailor saying his leaking boat works great until it's in the water. That's how they see the border. It works just fine until someone's crossing it. Now you have thousands crossing daily, and the media reverts to its usual amnesia. It's a crisis again, everyone.
This migrant situation is called a crisis, but you know what? That word is overused and doesn't do the situation justice. We're going to show you what's happening here. It's not easy to see. Let's shine a light on what is obvious. What do you say? Let's get after it.
After it.
Oh, boy.
But what do you expect? For 2 years, they were screaming that we had a Russian plant in the White House, never contemplating their hysteria's effects. Thankfully, smarter people kept them from destroying the country, even as they destroyed their own credibility. That's the bigger crisis, a failed media trying to tell you what matters. So, Kennedy, a child's view is something bad is happening now, let's fix it. An adult view is what's happening now, happened before, and can happen later, so we need a long-term fix.
Yes.
Isn't that what this is really about?
Yes, that's a good way of framing it, and Congress is supposed to be the adult.
Right.
Congress is supposed to be the body that looks at long-term effects of immigration and perhaps allowing people in the country who want to work and who want to help our economy and who want to fill some of the labor spots that are incredibly tight right now. Unemployment is very, very low. And we do need help from our friends from the South, from Central America and Mexico. Having said that, when you have people who are in limbo, they're torn between two countries. They want to go to the land of the free. They want to go to America. They want to help their families. They want to escape places that are run by drug cartels, but they can't. So what do? They rush for the exits, just like if you are in a concert hall and it catches on fire, you're going to have a stampede and people are going to get hurt. And that is what's happening here. Mm-hmm. And Congress is supposed to be the body that makes sure there are fire codes and fire extinguishers and plenty of exits so people aren't trampled to death.
An excellent analogy.
Thank you.
Jesse, I believe that she might have done a better analogy than your horse one from last week.
You still remember it.
I do.
That's
true. You know, shouldn't the Dems realize you can't create a country of great free stuff without a container that holds the free stuff? And that's kind of what a border is.
That's not what this is about, Greg.
Ah, damn it.
This is about the Democrats wanting to turn Texas blue.
Mm.
If Texas is blue, Republicans will never win another presidential election. You won't even have a conversation about the Electoral College. It's over. Forget about it. They'll win for the rest of eternity. So they don't have a solution for the border because they don't want a solution. They want open borders. Only a few of them will say that. They don't have the political courage. They'll hide behind things like it's not a crisis. You know, let's get some more beds for the detainees. It's not true. Have they even gone down to get a briefing from the Border Patrol? Have they ever even gone to Mexico or to Central America to talk to their counterparts? Do they want to change the detention policy, the asylum policy, the catch and release policy? No. We've listened to video on this show of Border Patrol agents say it's like a United Nations we're catching crossing. Albanians, Pakistanians, they're human traffickers, they're MS-13, they're gangbangers. They're literally bringing children who they don't know with them to cross the border because the minute they cross and set foot, we have to catch and release them and say in 2 years we'll see with the immigration hearing, but they don't show up. That's not a country. That's a lawless nation.
Juan, do you agree? I'm sure you do, that this is an attempt to turn Texas blue.
I love hysterics, but I mean, that's why you can't solve this problem, because people will say just off-the-wall things, and you got gangbangers and murderers and terrorists from Southeast Asia. I mean, it's just not true. Okay. Here's the thing.
No gangbangers have ever crossed to the southern border.
No, come on. This is like Trump yesterday. Trump says, Trump makes this, you know what, if I close the border, no impact. Mitch McConnell and the Republicans had to tell Mr. President, even the Chamber of Commerce had to tell Mr. President, that's going to damage the American economy. Don't do it, stupid. And it's just like, you know, he goes off and he says, people applying for asylum, only 3% show up for the hearings. Mr. President, it's closer to 90%. So he does things like separate kids from family.
Obama did that too.
No, Obama had unaccompanied minors. These are families. And so when he uses the term crisis, he uses things like, we're being invaded. This is an invasion. It's a military issue. No, what you've got is what Kennedy described. Families who say, you know what, it's getting harder with this guy's rhetoric and this guy's threats about a wall. And so we're going to try to put our children in better position to have economic prosperity. We'd like to come. Maybe we should go now because Trump's rhetoric is so divisive.
We'll go now because of his...
What?
All right, let me get Dana. Do you believe that it's Trump's divisive rhetoric that's enticing people from Central America?
Is your point that his threat to close down the border is...
Yeah, the whole thing, the wall, the border. I think it does send a message to people, if you're coming, you better go now.
So we'll see if that happens. We know that that happened with Obama. Remember when I can't remember what the decision was, but then all of a sudden you had all of these migrants coming because they were like, oh, my gosh, something's going to change. So they rushed.
But you could argue the opposite.
Sure.
That's the thing. It's a pointless point.
But to go back to your original point about the adult. Mm-hmm. So the issue really is laws and a court decision. Mm-hmm. The law being the asylum piece, the court decision being the one that you can't hold children for longer than 20 days. And so the point that if let's just say that it's true that 90% show up for their hearing. But if a million people are coming in a year or more, so we had 100,000 in March, that's a pretty big number.
Yeah.
And the president's approval numbers with Hispanics is on the rise.
Mm-hmm.
Why is that? Because they don't like this, and I don't think it's going to help them in Texas, the Democrats in Texas or Arizona or anywhere else.
Why are we assuming that every Latino person is going to automatically vote Democrat?
Well, and it's the truth. It's not true. That it doesn't happen, and the president's numbers are up with Hispanics.
Well, all right, we got to go. Did you want to say something?
They don't vote Republican.
Yeah.
Oh.
All right.